We threw 10 coolers into a tournament of thermals, a coliseum of Celsius calculating challenges, nay, a battle royale of benchmarks, all to crown the king of cold. And with our results in, we're starting to rethink our relationship with air coolers. With all the PCs we have built around here at Robeytech, we've used a number of CPU coolers, but in the past few years, we've seen a trend where builders have been favoring all-in-one, closed-loop liquid coolers over air cooling solutions. It makes sense. With the increased power draw and heat produced by modern CPUs, our collective consciousness has just assumed that AIOs are the way to go. Not to mention, they're just plain pretty and have so much RGB. In fact, we have our own song dedicated to them, which you're probably listening to right now, and it may be a platinum hit. However, we've had the privilege of testing several tower-style air coolers that quite frankly beat the snot out of or match performance with mainstream AIO coolers, but they do so at a fraction of the cost. Since this isn't the case across the board, we needed to choose a champion amongst air coolers. One cooler that could go toe-to-toe with an AIO, one cooler to rule them all, a cooler worthy of its own song, its own ballad, its own bard. So we decided to do a good old-fashioned shootout, a test of wills, if you will. Call it high noon because it's about to get hot in here. Because we ran CPU intensive tests and they all generated a lot of heat, which was kind of the whole point of all this. Just to give you a teaser, we had a clear winner and in some cases, it was a close one. So here are the ground rules for what you're about to see. Each cooler will be tested on the same benchmarking platform. Same parts, same test, same everything. And here is what the benchmarking rig looks like. We have Intel's Core i5-13600K and MSI's MPG Z790 Carbon Wi-Fi motherboard. It's got 32 gigs of Kingston Fury Beast DDR5 RAM running at 6000 megatransfer. We have the NVIDIA RTX 3090 Ti for our GPU, and for our PC case, the Lian-Li LandCool 3. The LandCool 3 is kitted out with 7 fans, with 3 120mm NF-A12s in the bottom mount position, and 4 140mm NF-A14s with 3 in the front, and then a single fan in the rear. Once each tower style cooler has been installed, we will record the CPU heat at idle across a 30-minute window. Thermal averages will be collected across 5 gaming benchmarks and averaged. And finally, we're going to crank the CPU to 11, collecting thermal averages under 100% load. After benchmarking, we'll look at their individual pricing and look at some fancy math to determine their relative value. Now, let's introduce our 10 contenders. We have not one, but two brawlers from Be Quiet, the Shadow Rock 3 and the Dark Rock Pro 4. Next up, it's Cooler Master with their Cooler Master MA824 Stealth, standing alone to represent the purple team. Next, we have the Deep Cool Twins, the AK620 Digital and the Zero Dark, both of which sound like they could be code names for people in the Matrix or the 1995 film Hackers. Hack the planet! And finally, Noctua sends 3 contenders into the arena, the NHU-12S, the NHU-12A, and the hulking NHD-15. What's this? A new challenger has appeared. It also looks like Deepcool snuck in one more challenger onto their team with ninja-like Mystique. The Deepcool Assassin 4 joins the competition at the last minute. What we kind of want to know is what happened to Assassins 1 through 3, but at this point, we're kind of afraid to ask. It looks like we have a crowd favorite here, the Thermalright Peerless Assassin PA120SE. This cooler has a huge following online and has collaborated with a number of TechTubers. It's gonna be a great day for competition because it's any cooler's game out there. Let's get to the action. We're starting out with a warm-up round where, well, it's pretty even playing field. The CPU idle challengers test our competitors' ability to keep cool under, well, no pressure at all, actually. Now, it looks like most of our contenders hovered in the mid-30s at idle, but it looks like the Noctua NHD-15 and the Deepcool AK620 Zero Dark are pulling ahead of the pack at 34 degrees Celsius. The Noctua U12A and the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro Far are keeping a steady pace in the middle of the pack at 35 degrees Celsius, fighting to simmer down even by the end. It looks like the Deepcool Assassin 4 is living up to its name by blending into the crowd alongside the Noctua U12S at a mid 36 degrees Celsius. The Shadow Rock 3 looks like it's a bit warmer than the rest. It just struggled to keep up with its skin, landing at 37 degrees here at the end of the CPU idle challenge. The word from the Deepcool AK620 Digital is that the CPU is not sweating, it's glistening at 38 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, the Peerless Assassin looks like it's having a rough start of the day as it ends the idle test with a score of 41 degrees Celsius. and it looks like the MAA24 lives up to its namesake because it is indeed the Cooler Master, sweeping the first gold medal of the competition at a cool 33 degrees Celsius. Looking at the scoreboard for the CPU idle competition, we have in third place, tying for bronze with a score of 35 degrees, we have the Noctua U12A and the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 4. In second place, trying for silver with a score of 34 degrees Celsius, we have Noctua's NHD 15 and Deepcool's AK620 Dark. And in first place, with a slight lead at 33 degrees Celsius, the gold goes to the Cooler Master MA824. Now, with everyone warmed up, we are moving on to the CPU powerlifting competition. We are here to pump it up. In this grueling challenge, each cooler is tasked with a job of cooling down their CPU while it hits 100% max output. Now let's go down to the competition floor. Out of the gate, the MA824 asserts its dominance by keeping CPU temperatures at 80 degrees Celsius. It looks like it's established a 2-degree difference between itself and the Noctua NHD 15 at 82 degrees, brute forcing its way to the top. You know what? That reminds me. Microsoft, when are we gonna be getting a remake of the 2003 tactical shooter Brute Force? I wanna be a bipedal crocodile with a gun again. But what is this? It looks like one of the two assassins got the memo. The Deepcool Assassin 4 saddled right up against the NHD 15, grabbing a silver medal for itself. As for the Peerless Assassin, it tried to copy the Deepcool Assassin 4's homework, but ended up tagging along with the AK620 Digital and the Noctua NHU12A. Unfortunately, it looks like we have some competitors who seem to be struggling, buckling under the pressure of this competition. Be Quiet's Shadow Rock 3 really got rocked in this challenge as it struggled to hold back the temperature at 90 degrees Celsius. At the end of the CPU power leveling competition, at the end of pumping it up with all the ion, in third place, tying for bronze, with a score of 84 degrees Celsius, we have three coolers. First, the NHU12A, second, the Deepcool AK620, and by the ever so slightest of hairs, the Peerless Assassin. In second place, tying for silver with a score of 82 degrees Celsius, we have the Noctua NHD 15 and the Deepcool Assassin 4. And in first place, taking another gold at 80 degrees Celsius, we have the Cooler Master MA824. Next up, we have the Gaming Pentathalon. It's a competition of shooting, driving, looting while shooting and occasionally driving, exploring and more shooting. This is one of the last chances for our competitors to show what they can do. Now, right away, we see the Shadow Rock 3 rally from the last competition, holding CPU temps at 63 degrees. It doesn't look like it's gonna be enough to get a medal because the Pentathlon is fierce. It looks like the Dark Rock 4 and Peerless Assassin have gotten into quite a bit of a fight, but they couldn't quite inch ahead of the other at 60 degrees. And for some reason, they're both clutching their legs like they have an identical soccer injury. What's that about? The Deepcool Assassin 4 is not sticking to the shadows. It's pushing its way into place alongside the Noctua NHU12A and the Deepcool AK620 Digital, but it's not enough to reach the Noctua NHD15's 57 degrees Celsius. And it's no surprise that the Cooler Master MA824 looks unbothered by this competition at all. At the end of the Gaming Pentathlon, we have in third place the Noctua NHU12A, the Deepcool AK620 Digital, and the Deepcool Assassin. In second place, taking home yet another silver with a score of 57 degrees Celsius, we have the Noctua NHD15. And in first place, content with nothing but gold at 56 degrees Celsius, we have the Cooler Master Master Air MA824. Now, as we get closer to our medal ceremony, there is one more opportunity for our air coolers to earn some validation. For this competition, our judges take the CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius, then subtract the CPU temperature under load from 100 degrees, and then divide it by the retail price. The resulting value represents the price in dollars per degree of cooling for each air cooler, which gives us some numbers that we can actually compare. In third place, we have a three-way tie between Be Quiet Shadow Rock 3, Deepcool's AK600 Digital, and the Master Air MA824 with a relative value of 4.99. In second place, the Deepcool AK600 Zero Dark inches ahead of the bronze category by 0.063 points. And marking up the podium like it won every competition, we have the Thermalright Peerless Assassin PA120 taking home the value of gold with a score that is just incredible. Overall, our air coolers put up a valiant effort in our battle royale of benchmarks. It's been a great day with mostly sportsmanlike conduct, but we do have some clear winners. In first place, with 3 gold medals and 1 bronze, the Cooler Master MA824 was a consistent champion across the board. Even though its price puts it at the higher end of our competitors, its cooling power was just inches away from totally dominating the games. In second place, with 3 silver medals, Noctua's NHD 15 proved to be a worthy competitor in the fight for the crown. However, when it comes to value, it did slip further down the rankings than we had hoped, especially consider that it costs more than the MA824. In third place, the Deepcool AK620 Dark ended the competition with 2 silver medals, while its twin, the AK620 Digital, ended the day with 3 bronze medals. Can we call it a tie? If we did, we'd have to make space for the Noctua NHU-12A here as well. Coming down to the end of the games, I wanted to talk about the Thermalright PA120 SE. The Thermalright PA120 SE was a late addition to the competition, but we felt it was necessary to showcase because of how popular it is and just how inexpensive. Is it an amazing cooler? In the field of competition, given what it's capable of achieving for that price point, yes. It's actually pretty amazing, but it comes at the cost in terms of quality and RAM fitment. Aesthetically, it's up to you if you like the Thermalright offering. That's a personal choice. How it's installed and its RAM compatibility is all about keeping the cost as low as possible. If you're about saving money and want the best cooler for the price, it's hard to argue that this isn't the right choice. But if you want aesthetics, ease of installation, and better RAM support options, then there are other entries in our Olympics that may fit you better. It's such an outlier in value that I just needed to call it out differently because, you know what, there's just something special about this cooler. Is it the best cooler? It didn't really shine in the idle and gaming arenas all that well, but when it comes to the price and the value, it kind of knocks things out of the park. So, let's wrap this up in a pretty bow, and all I can say is, are you not entertained, YouTube? We hope that you learned something today and that we were able to showcase just how powerful air cooling can be as an option for taming CPU thermals. Tell us down in the comments below if you have a favorite air cooler or if one of the coolers that we showed inspired you to build an air-cooled system. We have a ton of them over at Robeytech Live, and if you want to see them, we love to showcase them all the time, and we love to see your builds too. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.